Hey guys, it's your host MC Myra DeGosta and welcome back to my channel. Many clients have been calling in for bookings, but when it comes to the way of getting the things done for the wedding, many of us get so puzzled we don't know from where to start. Don't worry at all, I'm here right to explain you maybe a few tips of how to be ready for a wedding. I know, many of y'all must be wondering, hey, you're not even married and how can you say so? But trust me, it's 10 years of experience that's coming to y'all. So here is a video telling you 5 basic points that you need to keep in mind while you're planning a wedding. 1. Is the date and time. Well, many clients come in, you know, sometimes not knowing the date and the time of which they are planning on having a wedding. Well, there is a little pointer that I would like to give you. Whenever you plan a date, it is as per your choice and your liking and as per where you feel it would be convenient for your guests to come. It's all on you. And the time would be convenient as per your travel distance that you need to keep in mind, because there are sometimes proposals coming in from the north to south where you know you need to travel. In that case, you need to adjust the time according to your preference. Number 2. Always check out for the vendors beforehand and book them. This is a very important reason, is because you have this gorgeous wedding you want to do and it's a one in a lifetime kind of event. You want to give it your best, you want to have the best MCs, the best DJs, or the best bands, or the best photographers. But when you go for booking, they're just not there. So for this case, you always need to keep in mind that you go ahead and start booking your vendors way in advance. So it's very important first for y'all to target is your religious side of it, and then accordingly to the venue bookings and the other vendor bookings. You don't want to have a wedding where it's a different venue dates or the dates which you want are not available. So you got to keep that in mind. So point number 3. So once you have gone ahead and discussed about your, you know, people who you have, you somewhat get an idea on your budget that you have. Even at the time when you decide on the date, if you want to prepare the guest list, perfect. This gives you a better understanding in kind of focusing what kind of hall you want, or venue you want, or what kind of caterers you want, and who can also, you know, give you the up and down budget at that time. This gives you a really clear idea on what you want. And in this way, you don't miss out any of your favorite people being there on your special day. So once you have got your checklist done, the very 4th point is follow-ups. Now, there have been ample of cases that I have faced is where people call you for booking and then they just forget to follow up to inform you. Many a times there are weddings that, you know, happen in a, either they are preponed or postponed, some are even cancelled. So the vendor keeps on being hanging on a thin thread, thinking that you have booked them, but then there's no reply. So in this case, I would suggest you all to have a follow-up of the checklist that you have done. So this gives you a better idea and also helps the vendor, you know, you kind of help the vendor to be there for you and make sure he or she is there for you. And the 5th point that I want to keep in mind for all of y'all. Sometimes, in times of booking, things go up and down. You always have to have a backup plan. For example, you can book a venue which is indoor and outdoor. So in times, if suppose you're booking in, say, and there's a sudden rain, you can always have a backup plan of shifting your wedding to the indoor session of it. So this kind of gives you an upper hand that you're way prepared of maybe a drastic climate change or anything of that sort. And always be aware of what's happening around you. For us right now, it's the lockdown, and I know many people have been upset with it, but also on the upper hand, it has given you a chance to be safe and also keep others safe. So here are the 5 points that I have for y'all all while you prepare for your wedding or special events would help y'all. So one more deep advice that I really want to give my clients is, I've seen so many of y'all, you know, so excited doing the preparation, going forward, enjoying everything. But at the time when the wedding comes, your energies are so low and down, you don't get to enjoy it fully. So here is why my advice would be to kind of divide the work that will help you amongst friends and amongst your loved ones, all those who you can rely on. Or simply you can just hire an event planner who can help you planning out the entire session. And trust me, your wedding day is yours and you've got to enjoy it to the best. So don't forget to keep smiling on that. That's all for today, folks. I hope these 5 points have helped you out. And if you really like this video, please don't forget to leave your comments down below. And accordingly, I will prepare a part 2. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe and comment down below. And hit on the bell icon, please, to get more notification coming your way. Peace out, everybody. Take care and be safe.